internet. Will here. Welcome to day 7 at 5:47 a.m. in the morning, and it is Friday, which is RuPaul Day. Anyways, first off, before we start today's video, I want to absolutely, positively, 100% want to apologize for yesterday's video coming out so damn late. I'm more apologizing necessarily to myself because I was pissed. Like, everything just was not working out, and so now I'm using my cell phone as a way to upload a video. So just in case if I can't upload it on the computer, I can upload it directly from the phone, and I can type whatever I need to type, and then it will be done. So yeah, let's get started with this video. Okay, so today's video, I want to talk about body issues. Ironically, wearing this shirt, which I did wear yesterday, and please don't call me a pig. I know that it's a piggish thing to do, but what I do is that normally I take a shower at night, and then I wear a shirt, wake up in the morning, and then I kind of have it on all day, and then I don't take a shower that night, and then I wake up in the morning and then I take a shower during the day. It's weird. Anyways, let's move on. Alright, now I want to really talk about, like, my body issues. This is kind of stuff that I wanted to talk about yesterday, and I just didn't have the clear mind, and I felt like I needed to give you the backstory and hopefully understand that. Anyways, so I always hated my body. Always. I was always fat. I was always made fun of. I was always just a bunch of things. So, of course, you're going to have issues with your body. Now, the issues are not just... like, before, one of the things I loved doing was I absolutely used to love swimming. And now I don't swim anymore because that requires you to take off your shirt or wear a white shirt, and people can see through white shirts. So I'm not going to. Another thing is that I cannot go to the bathroom in public at all. Like, whenever I go to the stall or whenever I go to, like, anything, like, it won't come out. Like, no matter what, I can't go to the bathroom in a public place. That's not necessarily related to body issues. That's just something else. But I'm just calling it body issues because it's a mental thing. I do get depressed a lot. That's also considered a thing. But how do I explain this? Weight has always been an issue. And it wasn't until 2010 when I went to the gym that everything became, like, I started to gain some sort of motivation, and it was fantastic, and I liked it. Well, since I already told you that story, I guess body issues isn't going to be the thing that we're going to talk about today, but I just wanted to touch up on that and be a little more specific. So instead, we're going to be talking about the brain and my train of thought. God damn, my cats are scratching the damn scratcher thing, and it's driving me nuts. It is too early in the morning for that. Anyways. So, first off, I can't diagnose myself at all. I can't. But I can only tell you guys what I feel, and I'm not going crazy or not overthinking it, but, maybe. Anyways, I've been wanting to talk to a doctor, but I've been trying to find out which doctor should I speak to. And because I don't drive, and because the state sucks in terms of where everything is and where everything is near where I live, it's not easy for me. It's not easy to just go to a doctor and just whatever. I need to rely on a ride. I need to do all this stuff. You know, it's just a nightmare. And I hate it. Beyond belief, I hate it. But let's talk about it. So there's this, I was thinking that maybe at first I have anxiety attacks. These usually were common in older videos that you can clearly see that I was having an anxiety attack. I recorded a video on this channel maybe like about, I don't know, a year ago where I caught an anxiety attack or panic attack on camera, which was interesting. I can't really go back and watch it. It just seems so embarrassing, and the fact that it got as many views as it did bothers me. I didn't really want it to be seen, but maybe it, hopefully it helps somebody out there. And you know, it's just I don't know. So I've been dealing with anxiety for the majority of my life. But it only got worse as time progressed. Like before, I never used to be so scared of, you know, waking up and going somewhere. You know, one of the times where I would get panic attacks the most, and it would happen randomly, was before I had to go to work, which was the worst. Like every morning I woke up and I'm like, oh no, I have to go to work. And then it would bother me all day. Like it would bother me. Like the idea of going to work would destroy my, would like destroy my thoughts. I couldn't concentrate on video games. I start pacing around. And I just keep getting like a feeling in my chest and a feeling in my head and like a headache. And eventually, like when it gets to like minutes before I have to get out the house, I start to cry, to cry. And nobody really knew this except for there was a few episodes where I actually just cried before I went to work because I had to do videos every day. And it's embarrassing for people to see that. And especially, it just seems like it wasn't something to cry over. And a lot of people, you know, doing these videos is very embarrassing. It is. And a lot of people say, well, you know, don't be embarrassed about it. And I tell myself, don't be embarrassed about it. But, you know, sometimes, you know, you look at yourself and you're like, why the hell? There's times where I want to just delete the channel as a whole. Because of how embarrassed I was on what I said and whatever, and I said, look, I can't do that. In a way, I love doing this because it shows me how I'm growing, showing me what I think, and in a way, it's kind of giving me a photographic memory, but literally. So that's cool. So if I said something, I can go back and listen to what I said, what day it was. It keeps track of it, so I know what is happening. And it's like a way of, I guess, freeing my mind of thoughts that I have, and then I can go back, kind of like a Harry Potter pensieve, if you will. I've never been so. Like, then I thought I was just suffering from just panic attacks because there was periods in my life where I feel like I'm bipolar right now. Like, and I'm not like doing that like a typical person would use the term bipolar, like, oh my God, I'm so bipolar. You know, no, I'm talking about like possibly bipolar. So I started researching bipolar and that there's four versions of it, and I think I'm version two. Based on how it is. Now, basically, from what I understand with bipolar is that there's certain times, certain people go through things. There's experience a mania and an experience of sadness and depression. And some people get so unlucky that mania can mean a bunch of things. It means that you're constantly pissed off over the little things. For a while, mania could be that you're overly happy to the point where it looks crazy. Like, you'll do things like you'll do a lot of irresponsible things. Like, you would want to go rock climbing all of a sudden and stuff. And then sometimes, for some people, they love the mania feeling that you can do all this stuff and you can, you have this you just get this confidence and feel like you can do everything, but it's a very reckless way, depending on how bad your mania is. And then there's another sad side to it, where it's depression. And depression, when you feel depression, you feel depressed, depressed. Now, here's the worst thing about this bipolar. Some people, it's different for everybody, but there's some people who will be depressed for months upon months upon months, maybe like 4 months, I would say. And then there's some people who will be in the mania mode for another 4 months. And then so they'll be happy for 4 months and they'll be severely depressed. And it just kind of comes out of nowhere. You kind of feel it coming, but then you're just like, and you're like, no, I don't want it to go away. And then after that, you get depressed, and then everything is just depressing. Almost to the point of suicidal, or at the point of suicidal. There have been many people who have bipolar disorder who have tried to commit suicide, and that's what it is. Well, when I was researching bipolar, I was very depressed. I don't know honestly how long I was depressed for. I honestly couldn't tell you guys. I feel like it felt like it was like 6 months, like half of the year. And it just sucks. And it always seemed to happen like in July all the way down to December. And then in January it starts to wear off. And then like by February I was back to like a mania mode. And right now I feel like I'm still in mania mode, which is great, because like I feel more motivated, but it's not like a crazy mania. Like I'm like, oh my God, I have moments, but at this point I feel like now I'm excited about video games again because it's about to be E3. Video games feel fun again. Movies feel good. All this stuff feels like music sounds good and everything. So it's like I love this because I feel normal right now. I feel like how a person should feel right now. Versus when I get severely depressed, it's like I lose interest in everything. I start questioning everything. Like, why am I so sad? Why am I this? And sometimes I just want to know. Now, I'm not sitting here and saying I'm bipolar, because I'm just saying that I do have stuff like that and I could potentially be bipolar. And it could, I mean, it could possibly run to my family. I mean, I believe that there's some people in my family that have it and that showcase it. But a lot of the people in my family, a lot of people in the world, they don't count mental health as something that you need to worry about, something that you just need to tough through. Like, oh, look, I'm sad today, but I'm still gonna do what I need to do. And in a way, that's a cool thing, but in a way, that's just a really, crappy way. So like with everything, it's just gonna make you crazy, and if you don't check yourself mentally. Now, this coming from a person who hasn't even yet seen a doctor. See, I tried this doctor that a friend recommended, and it was in a perfect location. It was everything I wanted, but unfortunately, he doesn't accept like Medicare and stuff. And so now I don't know, with Trump being president, I don't know what's gonna happen with my Medicare. I'm glad that they overthrew the whole Trump care bull crap, but I really don't know what's going on. I'm just upset. And I want to be able to find somebody, and I really want to get help. I really do. I really, really do want to get help. But I just don't understand how any of this Medicare stuff works. Like I don't get it. Like when you're growing up, this is how I was growing up. My mother did everything for me. All the complicated shit, everything that was like that required you to actually speak to another person, required you to bring certain papers, required so like your little kid, your mom does all that for you, or your dad does that all for you, or whoever you live with does it for you, like an adult does it for you. You're in school, you're going to school, you don't learn anything about it in school, and though it's a real world issue, and then when you grow up, it just piles on you. By the time you're like, you have to move out of your mom's house or whatever, it piles on you, and it freaking sucks because it's like learning a new language and you don't understand anything, and it's a really annoying because you're like, oh, they're like, I need this paper, and I need this paper, and I need this paper. And then all of a sudden, you're just like, what the f what is that? And then you have to ask your mother anyway to help you. And she's like, no, it's this paper, it's this paper, this paper. And then you get into an argument because you don't understand what the hell is going on in communication because it's on the phone. So your mother would have to physically come here. You have to physically go to your mother with a bunch of papers, and then she has to pick them out for you, and then you go into the thing, you're like, okay, here you go. And then there's gonna still be an issue where they say, well, they need this paper because you don't understand all the paper lingo that they're trying to tell you, and you're explaining to your mom what it is, and then they, your mom only knows what so much because of the information you're giving her. It's not fun to go through that. And especially when it's college, it's not just like around that age, it's college, it's everything. And you don't get prepared for that. And that sucks. Like, it really sucks. So, me not understanding anything, I feel like a dumbass every day of my life. And I don't blame my mother, I don't blame anybody, I only blame myself. At this point, I just feel like a dumbass every day. I feel pathetic, I feel worthless, I feel just lost, and I feel like I can't help myself. I feel like I'm just weak and powerless all the time. Like, I just have no control whatsoever, and I feel like I have to always rely on somebody to help me. And and I feel like I would just be so lost to a point where I get so stressed out. There was a time I was living with my sister here in New Mexico. And she wasn't home. Nobody was home. I had the day off, or I think I was gonna go to work later or something. So I pretty much had the morning off. I just remember. I got a phone call from a number I didn't know. I picked up the phone, and it was somebody saying that I owed like $1,000 or something. Now, I don't know if it's true or not. I think it might have been a scam, but the stress of hearing that, I'm like, oh my God, $1,000. Because to me, with my job salary, that was possible, but it wasn't possible. Because I'm like, how am I going to pay my bills? How am I going to pay my cell phone? How am I going to pay like this and this and this? And then so I didn't have money saved up at that time. And it was such a sad time that I just wanted to just die at that point. Like, I really was considering it, like, at that time. Like, I'm like, this is so difficult. So I tried to call my mother immediately to tell her what happened. My mom just told me to just ignore it. And here I am shaken up because a lot of people just don't, like, you can't, like, the way my mind works, you just saying, get over it, or you just saying, like, you just can't say that to a person. You can't say that. That if it was that easy, where just like, oh, calm down. I'm like, that didn't occur to me. I mean, you try to calm down and you can't. You have to be talked down, and you have to be like, talk to calm down. Like, you're like, oh, everything's gonna be okay. Everything's gonna be good. Don't worry about it. You're fine. You're fine. You're fine. So then you want them to block every negative thought that you're gonna say out loud. But you can't really quiet the ones that you keep inside. So I've learned to try to control myself in front of people, but it ends up being attacked eternally. Like, I attack myself eternally, and it honestly kills me every time. It breaks my heart. It's a mental exercise because I'm trying not to show my emotions because I don't want people to worry. I don't want people to think things. But some days I just can't. Some days I do have an expression on my face. Some days I just feel, and then people are like, "Well, what's going on? What's happening?" It says, "Are you okay?" And I just tell them, "Yeah, I'm fine. I'm good." And I do a little fake laugh, and then I move on. I'm not fine. What's happening in that moment is usually I'm attacking myself. Sometimes I am fine, but I just attack myself. And I just hate it because I'm not one of the smart people. I'm not a talented person. I'm not anything. So I'm like, what do I do with my life? What am I doing? How do I do this in my life? And then at this point, I'm thinking, could I ever potentially be in a position where I can eventually get financially stable, where I could own a house and it's my house, like it's under my name. I can get a car, it's in my name. I have a cell phone, it's in my name. Like everything is mine. And I say to myself, no, I can't even see that. Like, I can't. Like, I feel like everything has to be under somebody else's name because I just don't have the responsibility to take care of it myself. I think the only thing I had under my name was cable. No, not cable. Internet. Internet was the only thing I had under my name. And it just sucks. I worry about things a lot because I'm more to follow the rules kind of guy. And there's a lot of people who live their lives like, they don't pay attention to the rules. And they get through just fine. They get through, everything is cool. They don't even gotta worry about it. They're like, I know what to do. Me, not knowing anything, I worry so much because I look at a website and it states the rules or it states what you have to bring with you. And I'm like, oh, but I don't have that. I don't have that. I don't have that. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. I'm not gonna be able to get it. And then my mom always has to calm me down. Like, I cannot count how many times me and my mother have gotten into arguments or just disagreements or whatever because of my way of thinking. My mother isn't wrong, but I worry because I'm reading something and then she just kind of just goes with the flow of something and says everything's gonna be fine. And that's cool. I love the fact that my mother does that. My mom does that, and I love her for that. But at the same time, I worry. Like, I worry until it's done, I'm good. But anyways, guys, that's today's video. Tomorrow, I don't know what I'm gonna talk about. I'm thinking about maybe talking about daddy issues, maybe, and then we could actually talk about and have a conversation about it. I guess I could talk about the relationship with my father and just my family in general. And I'm only gonna be able to speak from my side because I can't speak for my side. I can only speak for my side. I can't speak from other parties or what I think they think or whatever. So that's not for me to decide. Anyways, guys, it's Friday. Enjoy your weekend. If you guys are watching these or enjoying watching these or whatever, thank you. And I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.